Yo, what is up, gamers? Welcome to a new video. We're gonna be playing NASUS jungle right now in Diamond 3 Elo, so not too high, not too low. And we're gonna see how it works. This is gonna be my second NASUS game. I absolutely popped off the last game, so it should be very, very simple to dominate. NASUS is really broken right now. If you wanna climb Elo, all you really need is to farm until you're level 6, and then you can do whatever you want. The runes I'm running is Phase Rush with the ultimate one, when you gain movement speed when you press ultimate, and more movement speed when it comes to running towards the allies when they are snared or whatever CC. So I did the first mistake there. Should have waited with the Q. Doesn't really matter. We're gonna do rend golems, and then we're gonna go down into raids basically. We want to stack as much Q as possible. Obviously, I did fuck it up earlier, but it doesn't matter. We're going to be smiting golems here. We're going to also use a potion. You do want to get those last hits. Last game, I think in about 20 minutes, I had about 600 stacks, so it was amazing. I was one-shotting everything that walked. So, you don't necessarily need to, like, get all the last hit early. You still want to get your clear in. And last game, I did raids here, and it was really hard to do, actually. So this game, I'm actually gonna skip them. We're gonna move straight to... Okay, I get spotted here. I should have moved like this. It doesn't really matter. We're gonna move straight to wolves and then blue after. And this should be a little bit better. And then we're gonna actually... we just skip that one camp because it was a struggle to do. Doesn't really matter that much in the long run. Especially if you can maybe snag in a quick little scuttle on the bottom. Get a nice little snag there. And this game, I'm also gonna take 2 points in Q. So I'm gonna avoid Twitch. Even though, okay, that was pretty dumb actually. I should have not done that. It's fine. We wanna have 20 mana. And we're gonna smite at about 500 health. And we're gonna use Q right after. So if we can do that, demonstrate this. There you go, that's what we wanna do. Just gonna keep farming here. Twitch will stop, and he doesn't have blue buff, so he's gonna be clearing his topside jungle right now. That's fine. A little bit unlucky that Yasuo already gave out a kill, but that's fine with me. I don't mind it. Boom, stack there, and let's see. Bot scuttle should be up. Twitch had no real reason to do it, so we're gonna do this, get level 4 out of it, and then we're gonna take W, and then we might look for a bot gank. Looks to be pretty much free. I want to position Scuttle to actually move down like this. Galio got the return kill. Beautiful. We get a nice stack there. And now we're going to move bot. And we should honestly get a double kill here. I'm going long way. Yeah, they're both dead. They are both doomed. I'm going to go for... wait. They're going really interestingly, actually. So since I have phase rush, I'm going to get massive speed here. I don't know why this guy just griefed, but that's perfectly fine with me. The lane is gonna be aight. I'm gonna get a couple of stacks because I can. Oh, wait, we'll slow push, actually. It's not good for our bot lane, but I cannot really push it in time. I'll let them be. It doesn't really matter. I'll miss this cannon as well. Fucking. So the first thing we're actually gonna do is this. Great item. We're also gonna do this and that. Get a nice little ping going and get a red smite going. So... Sheen first. Obviously, we have automatic boots, so we cannot buy those. And you almost in all circumstances want to go for movement speed boots. Because with NASUS phase rush and everything is just so good. So we're talking these boots are what you want to get most of the time. You can get armor boots if you're against full AD team or whatever, but the speed boots work really, really well. And the beauty of this build is you actually scale perfectly on it. Like, your late game is beautiful. And you can split, you can do really all those things. It's really nice to play, you'll see eventually. Their Twitch is kind of popping off right now, which is not the most beautiful thing, but that's fine. 6, Twitch is this. Okay, Twitch went for the blue smite, that's pretty interesting. I'm gonna actually position myself here, so I should steal Yoink experience from the lane, I think. I'm gonna keep stacking. Do I get XP for this one? I do, that's what I wanted. So I think Twitch path topside there, so I'll just keep farming here. I want to get 6, and you'll see how strong the ganks are when you're level 6. You know what? I should place this pink probably either here or maybe somewhere deeper. I'll see. Not exactly sure just yet. Also, if you see what I do on camps, I hit the big guy, and then when I have my stack, I damage the small ones. I do it like that, for example. I think it is worth it. Oh, my red's coming up, so I actually want to get it. I actually want to get this one first. And then I'm going to back do this and then gank bot, I think. That should get me level 6. We're going to drop a... Okay, no words here. We're going to actually drop a ping here. That's fine. Now I'm getting this one first. Red, then top. I want to keep my mana somewhat okay. I don't really know if I want to gank top, gonna be completely honest with you. It's Jace after all. I don't think I have much potential there. Get this one real quick. Kai'Sa killed Twitch, that's beautiful. I'm actually rotating here. That was well played by Galio, actually. Let's see if I can do something here. Oh, that's tragic, actually. I should be able to gather, though. Oh, never mind. I don't know why Galio decided to ult there. Not the best, but I'll just get out of here. Have no mana, unfortunately. It is never ending. I'm just gonna mute the Yasuo because he's talking a bunch of nonsense. Usually the best thing to do when someone is just inting. So we're gonna wait actually 10 seconds for the blue, then back, and then see what I can do. I feel like Galio did a mistake there by ulting out. I don't know why he did that, but that's fine. My early game's not necessarily the best. Without flash, I also cannot do much. But it's fine. This build, I mean, this champion shines in late game anyways, so. We're gonna wait a little bit. Now we're gonna go back, get one more point in Q, and just keep farming. I still cannot get the boots for another minute, so that's a little bit unfortunate, but we're gonna get these, and that'll help, like, quite a bit. So we want to go Triforce, and after that we want to get Cinderhulk. It all depends on how much money you actually have. Like, if I have 1.1250, I'll go for Phage. If I have 900, I'll go for the Cinderhulk part. It all depends, like, how much money you have when you're back. Oh, that's awkward. I'll actually have to go top here. Yeah. I think I win this. Do I? Alright, he backs off, I back off, that's fine. My ult is actually very short cooldown, so I don't mind going for ult trades like that. He's pretty strong though. I don't mind it, as I'm gonna do the full jungle rotation anyways, I'll get my ult back before I want to fight anyone, so it's perfectly fine. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, this one. I'm actually gonna move bot here. I'll have my ult, I'll have everything. Don't have. I actually have my boots. I might get kited though. Hmm. Not much I can do there. If I had ult, I could go for that, but yeah. Just keep farming. As long as I'm allowed to farm, that's all I want to do. And it's looking good. We already have 250 stacks in 11 minutes. It's not perfect. Could have had a little bit more, but it's fine. Armor. This is the game where armor would probably be better. But you know what? Just for the sake of the video, I'll not do it. You know what? I'll just do this because I have 300 gold. I can eventually build it into... I can decide to... Nah, not this, but... I will eventually build it into this because I want to get movement speed run into people, you know? Okay, so their Yasuo is fat as fuck, which is... I mean, their JC is fat as fuck. I'm gonna rotate up here. I mean, I have him muted, then. Okay, that's fine. That's fine, that's a free kill for Yasuo. I'm gonna unmute him now, maybe he's gonna say something nice for a change. There we go, and now we're going back to farming. Back to farming, and when you're about to smite, let's say camps, when you're jungling, your Q will actually deal more damage than the smite. So what you wanna do is you wanna do E, smite, Q. Like, when you are about to smite stuff. And you need to know a little bit about your damage, right? So if your Q, for example, deals, let's say 500 damage, your smite deals 600. So at about 1k, you can easily E smite Q and it's gonna be safe. Small things like that are really nice on NASUS. Like, you can secure every objective like that. Okay. I'm just gonna keep farming until I have my ult back and see what we can do from there. I don't think I can duel Jace, not with that much mana. And not without ult, so. It's definitely not the type of jungler when you're gonna have a lot of pressure early. So you do wanna consistently farm up, and then eventually you're gonna be a beast. So that's the whole idea behind it. Okay, I'm gonna have my blue here. I wanna do blue, and then I'll look for a gank. Oh, let's go for this blue buff. And my gank should be really strong right now. The only problem is I am still squishy. I am still very squishy. So I want to have my ult. I want to have my flash for when I want to gank. That should be fine. And I'm maxing W, as you can see, especially against like Twitch, an AD carry like that. It is basically just like a long stun. It's really good. I'm waiting for my Q here. And the good thing is you don't actually need smite for the drakes and shit. Your Q actually deals more than smite, usually. Not yet, though. Might be able to do it, but nah, they know. They know. I wanna go for that. I don't have smite. I'll just kill this, as you can see, two Qs, and she's dead. And I'm gonna go for this guy as well. And this is where NASUS shines. That's what I mean. Look, we farmed for 14 minutes, and now I just one-shot their entire team. And that's the whole idea about it. Look at this, the damage right there. Beautiful. And now we're fat as fuck. Quite literally. We just got 4 kills, Drake, everything. And we have 400 stacks. And there we go. I'm actually just gonna... Nah, I need to back. Don't stay with that much money. I could rotate here on Jace, probably kill him. It's just not worth it, though. I wanna get myself what I wanna get myself. So, we're talking this. We're talking Cinder Hulk. And now we're talking. So now we're really strong. I don't have flash, unfortunately, but with ult and shit, I'm pretty tanky. I am out-leveling just about anyone. Look, I just basically two-shot an 8-1 Twitch. Their Twitch was so fed. Just gave me 1,000 money, just like that. And Twitch should be completely useless now, that I can just one-shot everything that walks. Just gonna keep the farming up though. Always wanna keep farming. And I think I'll be a little bit of a KDA player in this game. Okay, I need to rotate mid lane here. Just because I plan on making a video out of this one, so we'll see how this one goes. I know they have a ward here, I'll just clear that one. And you know what? I'm just gonna go for this. Okay, never mind, I'm backing off a little bit. Give me a stack. And we're just gonna go back to jungle, keep farming. We're unstoppable right now, it's looking good. Just gonna keep farming. Oh, not enough. One more, there we go. And as you can see, the ult cooldown is ridiculously low. 60 seconds, was that's a joke. So I'm actually gonna rotate bot here. There's no plant, unfortunately, but still fine. I'm gonna clear this ward and back, I think. Oh, never mind. Or maybe I'll be able to. No ult, though. It's a little bit unfortunate. I just wanna clear this. Oh. I'll just kill this, honestly. Holy fuck, are you seeing what I'm seeing here? Jesus Christ, this champion is a joke. Like, I'm two-shotting Lulu. Literally. Because I have... Look at my stacks. And that's what I'm talking about. That's why this is such a good low elo stomp champion right now. I mean, I'm in D3 right now. And I'm pretty confident I'll be able to just hard carry this game. Even though this Twitch is... a little bit worrying, but it should be good. Build a little bit of armor, should be fine. Okay, so we're talking blue Cinder Hulk right now, and then we're gonna go straight into Deadman's. We're just gonna run after people. And I have flash soon, ult up, so Twitch should be an easy shutdown for me. Wait, he doesn't even... He's 11-2 and doesn't give shutdown gold right now. That's interesting. Just look at this damage right here, 1200 on the boom. And that's what I mean with, like, when you smite, you want to smite before your Q actually goes off. It's like a small thing, but it gives you stacks after all, you know? But this guy's kind of griefing right now. I'll try to help, but... actually want to just go for that. Oh, that could be good, that could be good. I'm gonna go for this. Look at this. That's what I'm talking about. That's how broken this shit is right now. And my team is now starting to realize what I've been telling them. They just have to give me a little bit of a breathing room at the start to farm up, and then you become a beast. And this Lulu is a little bit too confident, I think. Actually, a bit greedy of me. I'll just, I want to do this pretty badly. I want Kai'Sa to move here. Yeah, I'll try to demonstrate what I mean with the smite. So, my Q deals about 700, as you can see. 700. My smite deals 800. That's 1.3k boom. Just like that. That's how you want to be smiting. Obviously, nobody was contesting it right now, but if they were, you need to know the numbers. You need to do quick maths. And it just helps, like, all in all. You're gonna be able to dominate games so hard with this. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna go do this camp and then back. Once again, the same rule from earlier. You do not want to be sitting on that much gold. And it's very easy to sit till like 5,000 gold. Like, it's very easy for me to start rotating here right now. I'm just not gonna do it though. I'm a greedy gamer. We're gonna take this one. And then we're actually gonna take, I think I'll go for Thornmail in this game. Ooh, Yasuo died. RIP. And could go for Frozen Heart, but not really feeling it right now, not gonna lie. And she's dead. Here we go. That's why we ignored this Yasuo. We don't care what he says, you know, he's 4-7 player. I'm just gonna carry him and that's it. That's all we need from that person. This looks very tempting. She's just gonna jump over, that's fine with me. And there we go. It still amazes me how much damage that actually does. I don't have smite though, but should still be fine. Hey Twitch, I heard you were a fan. Goodbye. And that's what I mean, man. It's that simple. 10-0, absolutely smurfing on these kids. And I think I'll be trying to get to Masters, just with NASUS, honestly. I think it's very easily achievable. Okay, let me try to demonstrate the smite thing I was talking about. So you test your damage. So what, about 200 actually with you? Ah, whatever, it doesn't matter. I'm just gonna do it like that. As a Thornmail. Actually, look at the money. Yeah, fuck it, let's do Thornmail. I wanted to go for Spirit, but I don't think Akali is ever gonna be able to damage me. I'll take Red. Be greedy when you play NASUS, be very greedy, do not give shit away. You are the beast in the game, not your team. Just look at this. 2 Qs, red buff dead. Just like that. We're looking at 134 Infernal here, so... definitely wanna get that one out of the way. I'm just gonna run them down. I have Flash, I have Ult, I have W. I'm literally just gonna run them down. I ulted, which is wasn't the best ult actually. Ah, not in time. Oh, I don't know why I did that. I actually thought it would recall instantly, but it didn't. Okay, we're gonna take this one real quick, and I'll have my ult back before the next fight. Ooh, not the best. My Q didn't go off there in time. Holy fuck. Like, look how disgusting that is. I mean, you don't even need to be good at the game. You literally do not need to be good at the game to play NASUS. There goes the health of the tower, literally, boom, dead. So if you guys struggle to climb Elo, give this a shot. Really, give this a shot. If you're interested at what runes I take and whatnot, you can always take a look at OPGG. It is, you know, you can easily just copy stuff. But we're just gonna end the game here. No joking around. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for watching this. This is how you dominate low diamond, I guess. And hopefully this is helpful for a lot of people that are hard stuck in diamond 4, diamond 3, whatever it is. And yeah, best of luck in your games. So thank you for watching this video. I'll see you around. Bye-bye.